The President's address is the vision of the government. It reflects the intention of the government. India has a unique parliamentary democracy. Today, queens do not give birth to kings. Kings are born of ballot boxes. We are proud that our democracy is continuously gaining strength for the last 67 years, and we also want to establish more robust democracy in the coming years. The present mandate is unique and has to be respected by all. While Shri Narendra Modi was pledging to remove poverty, corruption and unemployment, you were striving not to let him come to power. Shrimati Indira Gandhi won the election of 1971 on the slogan of Gareebi Hatao. When the disenchanted people try to elect someone else, you always term him as secular or communal. Have you forgotten the emergency era, the Hindu-Sikh riots and communal riots of Bhagalpur and the recent Muzaffarnagar riots? How long will you rant the Godhara incident which took place 12 years ago? Why are you trying to put a spoke in the moving wheel of the chariot of time? If the Honorable Prime Minister of India says that we will not tolerate any riot or crime, then you must have faith in his statement. The address speaks of eradicating poverty instead of alleviation of poverty. There are no two opinions that India is divided into haves and have-nots. Today, the condition of the poor is worse. They do not get proper food or medicines. When the Honorable President says, Ek Bharat, Shreshtha Bharat, he means that we are Indians first. When we say we are Indians, it means that the national interest is supreme. The party or individual interest can be taken care of later. Our education system needs total revamping for the purpose of putting in place a uniform education system for all. It is the Puna Pact through which the Dalits got various rights as well as reservation. I thank the government led by Shri Narasimha Rao for making provision of reservation in promotion. There was the UPA government for the last 10 years, but it failed to pass a single constitutional amendment for providing reservation in promotions. Today, the existing reservation policy is being governed by a government order. We have repeatedly demanded to convert this government order into an act and hope that the new government will do this. As far as the minorities are concerned, the government is committed to bring them into the mainstream and to have zero tolerance for riots. Here, people talk about majority and minority. When the people of the country are marching in one direction, why are some people talking about Hindus and or Muslims, or all the people of upper castes or lower castes or backwards or Dalits who voted for the government communal? All parties are in favor of women's reservation, but it has not seen the light of the day. It is the government of Narendra Modi which has given maximum representation to women in the cabinet since independence. Honorable President has said, Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao. He also promised to give 33% reservation to women. Is there any objection to these issues? Why these issues should not be supported? The younger generation has peculiar hopes and aspirations. Its mindset transcends the barriers of caste, creed or religion. It is not prejudiced. We demand that a commission for youth be constituted. The government has set forth the concept of linking of rivers. The country is facing floods on one hand and drought conditions on the other. Once the work of linking of rivers is completed, no field will remain unirrigated and India will not be dependent on others. We will implement one rank, one pension scheme. The government of India provides subsidized ration to the poor. First, it was given through Antyodaya program, then BPL, and now Food Security Act is in place. In spite of all these efforts, the poor are not able to get rations. The supply of ration in Bihar is 4 lakh tons against the demand of 23 lakh tons. We are committed to provide ration to the poor, and the cooperation of the state governments is very important for this purpose. Many governments are doing remarkable work in this regard. The government of Tamil Nadu is distributing free ration, and Chhattisgarh has excellent distribution system. The sugarcane growers in Uttar Pradesh are in distress. It is also said that we will maintain peace with our neighboring countries. We are a big country and will play the role of an elder brother. We will try to pick up the thread from where Shri Atal Bihari Vajpayee left it. Who does not want to see a powerful Prime Minister at the center? We are powerful only when our country is powerful. There is no dearth of policy in the country, but of intention. Our policies are clear and intention is clear, so we will succeed. This is the first time since the last three decades that people of the country have given a clear majority for a single party. I congratulate the Honorable Prime Minister for that and my best wishes to the new government. The President appreciated the people for having voted for stability, honesty and development, where corruption has no place. I had raised the issue of 2G spectrum scam many times in 2009, that is in the 15th Lok Sabha. The people of Tamil Nadu have punished the perpetrators of 2G scam in May 2011 elections. You may call it any wave. According to me, the only wave is anti-corruption wave. So many VIPs, former ministers from Tamil Nadu and former chief minister's family members were involved in corruption, but no action has so far been taken against them. People have given their verdict, and we hope that the new government will take a serious action against the culprits and they would be punished. The President talks about poverty elimination in paragraph 7 of his address. The Supreme Court gave a judgment that the stock of food grains which is lying in the godowns is completely rotten and rats are eating it. The government should distribute it to the people free of cost, but they did not do that. In Tamil Nadu, our leader Jaya Lalita ji gave food grains free of cost. If you are charging rupees 3, it is not food security. The government is having plenty of stocks. As regards marriage assistance, our leader is implementing a scheme under which 4 grams of gold and up to rupees 50,000 are given for marriage expenses. So this is a role model which we should follow. So many models of development are being quoted here. I would request you to take Tamil Nadu as a model. Our Honorable Chief Minister is the pioneer in implementing all such welfare schemes. A corruption-free government is running in the state of Tamil Nadu. The Congress government failed to take action in this matter, and thus they lost the elections. The minimum support price for agricultural produce has to be increased. From ancient times, agriculture has been our mainstay. If you fail to accord primacy to agriculture, definitely our country is going to face a lot of problems. I would therefore like to congratulate the Honorable President for having mentioned about the agriculture sector. Since our economy is dependent on agriculture, how can we have farming without interlinking of rivers? The government should allocate more funds for modernization of the police force. We have to give top priority to the modernization of police. The government should also try and recruit more intelligent people, service-oriented people and committed people in the police force by giving higher salary to them. We are talking only about the pollution of the river Ganges. All the rivers of the country are polluted. Therefore, do not think that the Ganga is the only river to be cleaned. Our forefathers preserved all the rivers so that we will be able to get good drinking water. The government should draw a master plan and see that any sort of materials causing pollution must not go to the rivers. You must give priority from the beginning itself and see that the central government sanctions sufficient funds. State governments have no power to impose any tax.